Well, thank you very much, Amany, for joining me today to talk about your fantastic achievements here in engineering at UCL as part of the INWED 2020 celebrations. I thought maybe we could just start by, if you could just tell us a little bit about your area of study.
You know, I'm currently a member in the Information and Communication Engineering Research Group at UCL. I'm doing a PhD degree in electronic and electrical engineering that is focused on the development of optimized electronic circuits, especially to increase the transmission speeds in visible light communication. I mean, my PhD covers the whole engineering process, starting from the design, comparative studies, optimization, experimental work, site of the process.
Wow, very impressive. Yeah. So who or what inspired you to want to study engineering?
I'd say that as a kid, I was always very curious to know how things worked. I also liked math, so engineering seemed like a natural choice for me. But also, having grown up in Egypt, I always had this desire to make a difference in my surrounding, even if little, just by setting an example for young girls that they can pursue their passion, study engineering or whatever is it that they like. Especially maybe in a region where women are not generally encouraged to be engineers and they're largely underrepresented in STEM areas.
Okay, it's very inspiring.
Thank you.
And what's your favorite part of your study and your research?
As a researcher, my favorite part is getting to build my own designs. I mean, that's the most exciting and rewarding part, is to see something that I've worked on so hard just functioning the way I'm expecting it to function. And generally like more like practical hands-on experimental work rather than theory. Just feel like I learn more from it and it's more fun.
And what's the most valuable lesson you've learned in your studies so far in your research?
I'd say probably perseverance, just learning to deal with the frustration of sometimes building circuits that does not work as expected, or just trying to understand a concept that is new, is difficult, is definitely the hardest part of it. I mean, just finding the confidence and the, I say, the excitement to keep on going and just persist to get things right and to understand them and just accomplish what I want to accomplish.
Can you describe a typical day in the life of your research, obviously before all the change in circumstances?
My day has varied throughout my PhD. At the beginning of my PhD, I tended to read more papers, get familiar with the literature, which required me like to spend more time at my desk in the research office. But more recently, towards the end of my PhD, my focus shifted to more practical work. So I spend more time in the lab. Mm-hmm. I mean, there is other activities that I do, just working. I mean, there is socials. We usually used to have, you know, group lunches, which was very nice, and hopefully we'll be able to do that soon again.
Yeah, so it sounds quite varied, which is interesting.
Yeah.
And how would you say the current situation with COVID-19 has affected your work?
The interruption of my experiment work in the lab, especially that the lab is closed, and some of this work I feel is, you know, is very important to the completion of my PhD. I'm trying to use the time to write part of my thesis and my final thesis, just so that I'm not wasting time. And this is something that I can do remotely. Also, not having any kind of physical face-to-face interaction with my supervisor or other group members sometimes can you know, give some sense of isolation. Now we try to Zoom all the time and stay in touch, which is great. It's something to compensate for the distance.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And finally, what advice would you give a younger person or even your younger self who wants to enter the field of STEM?
It's probably less of an advice and more of a realization. It's something that I realized when I started studying engineering, it's that it's not as intimidating as it looks or as other people make it to look. And probably just because, you know, other people or maybe perhaps friends perceive it as a hard subject doesn't mean that I should have opted out or should have chosen to study engineering. Some subjects like are indeed challenging, but I feel if given the sufficient time and effort, they can be very rewarding.
Yeah, that's great. That's really good to know. Thank you. Yeah,
thank you. Thank you.
Thank you ever so much.
Thank you.
All right. Lovely to meet you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Nice to meet you too.